Greetings, fellow detectives. Wizard Kitten here, bringing you my review of the 20th mystery in the Nancy Drew series, Nancy Drew, Ransom of the Seven Ships. As usual, my reviews are based on five separate categories: plot, characters, setting and design, entertainment and gameplay value, and music and vibe. Each category is scored on a scale of 1 to 10 for a final possible score out of 50, and then I assign each game a letter grade based on that score as well. So without further ado, let's get started with the plot of Ransom of the Seven Ships. Basically, for this mystery, Nancy's friend, Bess, is awarded a vacation through a sweepstakes. Bess wins a vacation to the Bahamas, and naturally she decides to invite her cousin George and Nancy along for the trip. Nancy has to arrive a day later than Bess and George because she already has a previous engagement with her dad, some sort of function that they have to go to together. So when Nancy arrives a day later, she mysteriously hears from George that Bess has been kidnapped and a letter was left behind insisting that Nancy find a treasure that is supposedly buried on the island and was left by a pirate or a captain called El Toro, whose ship supposedly sunk in the area and then supposedly buried his treasure on Dread Isle, the island where they are vacationing. So obviously this is a big problem for Nancy. She now has to find this treasure, and she now also needs to try and find Bess. I like parts of the plot. I really do like parts of this plot, and I think parts of it have good potential. I like the idea of Nancy needing to go find a long-lost treasure that a pirate left behind that nobody has been able to find. I love that idea. That's a great idea. I also like the idea of Nancy needing to save her friend Bess, being kidnapped and having to find her. That has worked out as a plot point in the past, when Nancy's friend Maya goes missing in the final scene, for example. That would also be a very good mystery. Do you need to put the two together and make them related to one another? No, you do not. Putting them together minimizes both of those potential plot lines. The reasoning they have for this is that the culprit that is setting this whole thing up knows that Nancy likes solving mysteries and is good at mysteries, so naturally the culprit thinks that this is a great way to get the treasure, to get exactly what they want. The culprit also doesn't like Nancy, so they feel like this is a way to get revenge as well. While this might seem logical, it seems like a good idea in theory, but when you put it into practice, it just does not work. And it's so incredibly frustrating because there is so much potential. The two plots just do not go together poorly. They do not balance each other well at all. The plot is also extremely, extremely puzzle-driven. I have nothing wrong with puzzles as long as they seem functional to the plot, as long as they don't feel contrived and they are there for a reason. There are so many puzzles in this game that feel like they are put there purely for the purpose of making the game longer and more difficult. I am looking at you, monkeys. Those little monkeys are purely there to make the game longer and to hide things that Nancy needs and make the game longer by making her play these extremely frustrating puzzle games in order to get them back. There's really no reason for them to be there, and they could have done the hiding of those objects in a much more clever way that also would have seemed more realistic and less contrived. There's also the issue that there are very few characters in this game, and I'll talk about this more in the characters section, but we have Bess and George as physical characters in this game, and we have Johnny Roll, a Jamaican beach bum, who's on the beach where Bess disappeared. We also have monkeys and Cuckoo the parrot, who is a distant relative of Lulu the parrot. Who do you think is the culprit? Let's think for a second. Is it the monkeys? Is it Cuckoo? Is it Bess or George? Probably not. There's only one other character on the island. There are several false flags that are presented to us throughout this mystery, which would have made the plot much more interesting had the false flags actually had any truth to them or any possibility to them. Nancy can't follow up on these false flags at all. There's a couple times when it seems like maybe the Gibsons are the ones, the people that own the resort that aren't on the island. Maybe it seems like they're the ones that could be responsible for this whole thing. There's these apparently mysterious other people on the island, but we never actually follow up on any of these threads, and they don't seem plausible enough because, one, this has never been the case in any other Nancy Drew mystery where the culprit randomly shows up in the end and we've never seen them before. That's never happened, so why would it happen in this mystery? It just doesn't seem to make sense. And two, there's just not enough evidence to support those other theories, so we are left with a very obvious conclusion. There is, I will admit, a twist with the culprit. However, that twist relies on the player having played a previous Nancy Drew game. When I first played this game, I had not played the game that the player needs to have played in order to understand the culprit reveal. I'm trying to leave this deliberately vague so that there's only mild plot spoilers for this review. But I hadn't played that game, and so the culprit reveal didn't make any sense to me. And even after I have played that previous game and now play this game again, I still feel like the culprit reveal is just really lazy. It's just, it doesn't seem like it was necessary, and it seems like it was written off as something like a really easy plot. They needed a scary culprit, so hey, let's bring this person in and try to make things seem like a really cool twist. It just doesn't work, and it's really not necessary. They could have easily designed a more intimidating culprit. They could have had more human characters on the island that could have also been more intimidating. One, there could have even been another human character that could have taken the role of the monkeys and like had all of these treasures that Nancy needs to get. It's just, it's not great. The plot doesn't function if you don't have multiple possibilities for a culprit. The one other issue that I have with this plot is that there is too much revealed by the culprit at the end of the game that we didn't know during the previous parts of the game and that we had no possible way of finding out. I believe it's very important in a mystery for the person reading, playing, or watching the mystery to be able eventually to put the clues together themselves and get close to finding out the right conclusion on their own. This game does not make that possible because it keeps all the information we would need to fully come to a conclusion locked up with the culprit, and the culprit reveals it right at the very end, which again I feel like is lazy in mystery writing. I appreciate a mystery much more when it leads the detective to the right answer on their own using all of the clues that are available. So long story short, very long story short, the plot of Ransom of the Seven Ships had potential, but I feel like it failed in almost every other respect. It was really, really unfortunate. So I give the plot of Ransom of the Seven Ships a 2 out of 10. Next, we move on to characters, which I have already touched on. We have Bess and George as physical characters for the first time in the games. It is very exciting to see Bess and George. That is very cool. We only see George for a majority of the mystery, Bess we only see for a short time. Again, we also have the monkeys, and we have Cuckoo, who is basically downgraded Lulu. Lulu was a character in Curse of Blackmoor Manor who was a parrot that was actually really helpful to Nancy in giving Nancy hints and information about the castle and the Penvelin family. Lulu played an important role. She was helpful. Cuckoo, her role is to be annoying, frustrating, and time-consuming. It really is. Cuckoo does not help Nancy in any way. Cuckoo just annoys Nancy and makes Nancy do chores for her. She's downgraded Lulu in every sense of the word. And I'm treating her as a character because we don't have any other physical characters in the game besides Johnny Roll. My assumption is that they had to do this because they made the choice to have Bess and George be physical characters, and they could only afford slash have the time to make a handful of physical human characters, which means that Johnny Roll, the last physical character, could be the only other non, like, friendly character, which, again, is a huge problem because you have this big part of the plot that really doesn't even matter, because who is going to be the culprit on the island when all of the false flags don't line up? Again, yes, there is a mysterious culprit reveal at the end, but there's a lot of problems with that, as I mentioned before. The biggest issue that I have with characters is that there are so few. There's only one that could potentially be a culprit, and they made a decision to basically make monkeys and cuckoo a character in their own right, which I think was a really unfortunate decision in a mystery. So the characters feel extremely lacking. The interactions we have with the characters just are not good. They are, with George, either very desperate or very short. With Johnny Roll, it is Nancy asking for information, usually being told no, then being told yes as long as she does something for him. That's really the only way that those interactions go. With the monkeys, it's I'll play a game, hopefully win the game eventually, there you go. With Cuckoo, it's run an errand for me or give me fruit. The interactions are so very simple and so very base that they get very boring very quickly and do not add anything special to the game. So unfortunately, I need to give characters another 2 out of 10. Next, we move on to setting and design. This is the one place that I think this game succeeds. This game takes place in the Bahamas, which is a tropical location, and it is beautiful. They do a very nice job doing the waves on the sea. They do a great job doing the jungle locations when Nancy is walking around. You have these beautiful pink and white sandy beaches. You have these really cool caves. You have underwater caves, which are really nice. Nancy can go sailing and scuba diving and see all of these great tropical locations. I think that is all awesome. Do I think the setting and design is perfect? No, I do not. The one issue that I have with setting and design is that there's a lot of third person. Over 50% of the game takes place in the third person perspective, which immediately removes the player from feeling immersed in the game. When you're third person, you're at a bird's eye view, so you're really not getting a great sense of the design because everything is two dimensional. You are getting the tops of trees. When you're sailing, you're getting literally just a blue sheet of water. That's nothing special. That's really easy to do, and that doesn't make me feel like I'm in the location. It makes me feel like I'm playing a computer game. And when I'm playing a Nancy Drew game, I want an immersive experience. I want to feel like I'm in the location that it is being portrayed. And the game does do this pretty well in all of the other physical locations. It is not exploration heavy, despite the fact that there are a lot of locations. Really, the locations are only there for a different set of puzzles. But the ones that are there are nicely done. They look pretty. I just wish there was more emphasis on exploration and less emphasis on third person. Overall, though, I give setting and design an 8 out of 10. Next, we move on to entertainment and gameplay value, which considers how fun the game is to play and how fun it is to replay. Now, for me, a lot of the fun parts of Nancy Drew games come from having a really intricate and exciting storyline, really interesting conversations with characters, and puzzles that are challenging and important to the plot. As I have already mentioned, this game really doesn't have any of that, which is really unfortunate. The plot is not great. The characters are not great. This game is extremely puzzle heavy. So puzzle heavy that I think 80 to 90% of this game is completing puzzles or driving around in a golf cart or a sailboat. Eventually, this gets really boring and really tedious. Nancy needs to do these things so many times throughout the game that it just gets really old really fast. I mean, sailing is fun at first, but when you have to sail back and forth over and over again to do a colorful Sudoku puzzle, eventually you're going to get really sick of it. Same thing with moving around in the golf cart. It just is not as much fun as it seems like it should be, and a lot of that has to do with the really lackluster plot, the lack of characters, and the overarching emphasis of the puzzles. The puzzles are fun, but again, when you're doing puzzle after puzzle after puzzle and you have no break in between for anything else, it gets really old really fast. So unfortunately, I have to give entertainment and gameplay value a 3 out of 10. Finally, we move on to music and vibe, which considers the music of the game and the overall feel of the game. Now, typically, this is a really high category for me. I typically rate games pretty high here. This is a game that I rate really pretty low in the music and vibe category for a couple major reasons. This game takes place in a tropical location, and it's very difficult to make a tropical location feel mysterious. I don't have a problem with that necessarily. For example, Creature of Kapu Cave took place in a tropical location, but I gave it a 7 out of 10 because it still gave off some adventure and danger elements. This game takes place in a tropical location, but never feels dangerous. There is no sense of urgency or danger in this game whatsoever, despite the fact that there are so many things that should be making Nancy feel nervous. So, for example, her best friend Bess is kidnapped. Nancy's reaction is so nonchalant, it's almost painful. If you go back to another mystery where Nancy has a kidnapped friend, the final scene, Nancy is out of her mind with worry. She is angry. She's yelling at other characters. And they make a point in the mystery to call her out on, are you too personally connected to this mystery to be able to solve it? This is really worrying. In this game, Nancy is just like, oh, Bess is missing? Guess I'll go find her. Except she's not really trying to find Bess. She's trying to find the treasure to then find Bess, which again diminishes the urgency of the entire mystery. Nancy's not actually doing anything to find Bess. She's doing everything to find the treasure in hopes that it will eventually help her to find Bess. That sense of urgency needs to be there in a kidnapping mystery, and it really brings the vibe down. Another thing that brings the vibe down is the music itself. I really enjoy the music. It's really light, it's fun, it's tropical, it's got kind of a like Hawaiian type feel, a jungle type feel. But when you put that type of music over situations that are supposed to feel dangerous, like for example, when George is trying to save Nancy from the cave and Nancy is like suffocating inside, there's this really happy tropical like do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do music playing in the background, and George is supposedly saving Nancy's life, but the music is telling us that things are going to be fine. Everything's fine. This is a happy-go-lucky, fun mystery, despite all of the danger that we could be getting from it. So there really was a lost opportunity in music and vibe. There needed to be more matching of the tracks to the actual mood of the scenes and of the mystery. There needed to be more of a creepiness factor. The music is great, and I love the music, but it just brings down the vibe. So I overall give music and vibe a score of 4 out of 10. So when we add up our scores, we have a 2 for plot, 2 for characters, 8 for setting and design, 3 for entertainment and gameplay value, 4 for music and vibe, for a total score of 19 out of 50, which is our lowest rated Nancy Drew game yet. Ouch. This gives us a grade of an F for the game. Now, I've been harping on this game a lot throughout this review, and I have not said a whole lot of positive things about it. So you might be thinking, should I even play this game? Is it even worth it? It is worth mentioning that I grade these games against each other. I do believe that Ransom of the Seven Ships is a fun game to play, and I do think that it has an important place in the Nancy Drew series as a whole. I would still recommend playing it simply for the fact that it is a Nancy Drew game. Because it's part of the canon, it helps you understand Nancy's history, where she's been, where she's going. It's good for that reason. However, if I were going to choose to play a game out of the series, Ransom of the Seven Ships would not be my first choice. It would eventually be a choice, but it wouldn't be my first choice because it lets me down in so many different ways. The plot just is not great. The characters are really not great. It's not really that fun, and it doesn't feel dangerous like it could. It doesn't need to be scary, but it needs to feel like there are actually some stakes in order for this to be a mystery game or even an adventure game if they're going for that angle. There just needs to be more to it. However, this game does have some positives. If you are a puzzle-loving detective, you will adore this game. If you don't want a game that's scary at all, like if you really are troubled by scary games, maybe you're a younger detective, or you just are a little bit sensitive to more scary things, that's totally fine, and this would be a great game for you because of that. It's very light, it's very fun, it's got a lot of great puzzles. I just would not call it a great mystery. Thank you so much for watching this review, fellow detectives. I really do hope that you enjoyed it. I enjoy making these reviews and walkthroughs, and will continue to do so until I've finished all the games in the series. Please let me know what you think about this game in the comment section down below, and please feel free to subscribe if you're interested in seeing more reviews. Thank you so much for watching, fellow detectives. I will see you soon.